Hi, my name is Edison Tam. I'm a senior design engineer here at PEmicro, and today I'm going to provide an overview of our Cyclone production programmers. We will start off with an introduction of production programming and then show a demo where we can see the Cyclone in action. So what is production programming? It is one of the last phases of any embedded systems project where development is complete, boards are manufactured, and need to be programmed with final firmware. Engineers often discover the requirements of production are very different than that of development, and the Cyclone is specifically designed to address all of these needs. The higher volume of boards puts a focus on using a robust programmer with fast programming speeds, as programming time directly affects the cost of the product. Technicians on the production floor need a programmer that is simple, repeatable, and automated to eliminate the chance of human error. Dynamic data that varies from board to board, such as serial numbers or MAC addresses, often present a daunting problem unless the programmer is specifically designed to handle this type of data. Let's now go over the features of the Cyclone to see how it solves all of these challenges. The Cyclone is a standalone production programmer, which means after some initial configuration, it is capable of programming Flash without needing a connection to the PC. This is often the biggest bottleneck during Flash programming, and by removing this bottleneck, the Cyclone is able to achieve extremely fast programming performance. In the simplest use case, programming is as easy as pressing one button on the Cyclone, making the programming process repeatable and error-free. Let's look at the Cyclone in more detail. On the right side are the power supply barrel and the PC connectors, Ethernet, USB, and serial, which are needed initially to store a programming image onto the Cyclone. The LCD touchscreen provides real-time status information, along with easy access to configuration options, such as selecting the desired programming image. Underneath the screen are color-coded success and error LEDs. The left side of the case opens up to provide access to all of the debug connectors, and also the jumpers, which control providing power to the target. We'll now go over a typical use case. The first step is to create the standalone image which defines the desired programming sequence. This is done with the Cyclone Image Creation utility. First, we need to select the processor architecture and part number. Next, the user can specify the desired programming operations. A common sequence would be to erase the flash and then program and verify an object file produced by the compiler. In this example, we will also configure the Cyclone to generate 3 volts, which we'll use to power the target processor directly through the ribbon cable. Now, all we have to do is click on Save Image to Cyclone, and the programming image will be created and downloaded to the Cyclone's onboard memory. Once these steps are complete, the PC connection is no longer needed. The Cyclone can now be moved over to the production floor. After connecting to the target board, a simple press of the start button will begin programming operations. The LCD provides real-time feedback on programming progress, and the status LEDs indicate programming results. For users who are interested in further automation of their production line, the Cyclone Control Suite is a software package included with the Cyclone that allows the user to write their own PC applications to control the Cyclone. For example, an application can be designed to start programming operations on 3 Cyclones simultaneously, program different dynamic data, and finally report the results back on screen. The Cyclone standalone programmer comes in 2 series: the Cyclone and the Cyclone FX. The Cyclone series are fully featured standalone programmers while the more advanced Cyclone FX series offers faster programming speeds, more storage for images, enhanced security features, and advanced automation features. Both series support ARM processors from a wide range of manufacturers, as well as 8, 16, and 32-bit processors from NXP and STMicroelectronics. For the most up-to-date list of supported processors, please visit our website. Thank you for watching, and please stay tuned for more videos from PEmicro. For more information about our products, please visit PEmicro.com.